Welcome to our cardiac rehab home exercise video. My name is Jara and this is Blake. Before we get started, I just want to say a couple things. Make sure that the area that you're going to be exercising in is clear of anything that could maybe trip you. So no area rugs, no cords. Maybe even if you have a small pet, you want to make sure that they're not in your way either. Also make sure you're well hydrated or you have some water close by. Also remember that if you're going to use a chair for any of the seated exercises, that you make sure it's not a rolling chair, it's a good sturdy chair so you don't fall. We would also like to advise that all participants take full responsibility for their safety and know their limits. Exercise is not without risk, and this or any other exercise program may result in injury. Those could include, but are not limited to, the risk of injury or aggravation of a pre-existing condition, such as a muscle strain, also abnormal blood pressure or heartbeat, fainting, or in very rare instances, a heart attack. As with any exercise program, if at any point during your workout you begin to feel faint, dizzy, or have a physical discomfort, you should stop immediately, rest, and consult a physician if it does not go away.
As far as exercise equipment goes, some of you may have access to equipment at home. Really all you would need for any of these workouts is just a pair of dumbbells. If not, you can be a little bit more creative. So we have some things like laundry detergent, gallons of water or milk, and then even shampoo or conditioner. So kind of keep in mind what the weight would be of those items. You want to keep it on a lighter scale just because we are doing high repetitions. And then as far as exercise intensity goes, do keep in mind that we're aiming for a moderate intensity. Nothing too difficult because, again, we are going to kind of ride out that duration of the exercise. So this warm-up is a 10-minute AMRAP. What that means is we're doing as many reps as possible for each one of the four exercises listed, and we're going to cycle through for 10 minutes total. So I'm going to demonstrate kind of a regular moderate intensity exercise, and then Jara is going to show you a modification that's a little bit lower intensity. So the first one we have is jogging in place. So with that, you just want to pump the arms, lift the knees. You can see it shows 15 seconds. So with that, just kind of do your best to guess around what 15 seconds would be. And then Jara has a modification for that one.
So the modification for us is going to be to stand behind a chair. Remember, you don't want your chair to have wheels on it. And you're going to just kind of do some high knees as you hold onto the chair for balance.
The second one is a single leg kickback. So you'll kind of feel this one more in the hips. Traditionally, what we're going to do, I kind of like to keep my hands on my hips just to help me stay balanced. You're going to alternate legs, so you're just going to kind of bend your knee, extend that leg back behind, bring the knee back forward, and then I just do 10 on each side before I then switch to the other leg. Again, you might find that one side is a little harder to balance on. That's okay.
All right, and a simpler version of that would be you're going to sit in your chair, you're going to take your one leg, you're going to step out, and then just step back in, and then do the other side, alternating. Out and in.
And with the standing one, if you do need to hold on to something like the back of a chair during that, that's perfectly fine. The third one is push-ups, everybody's favorite. So if you can do a traditional push-up, that's what we're aiming for. Hands about shoulder width apart, you're going to go down and then extend back up with the arms. Looking for 10 total.
And if you can't do that, you can always do a wall push-up. So you want to find a wall or something sturdy. Your hands, again, are going to be about shoulder height. And then you're just going to take your nose to the wall, push yourself back for a total of 10.
All right. And the fourth one is a chest pull with a leg curl. So this is kind of two movements combined into one. The first one, we're pulling the arms in towards the chest. And then whenever you feel comfortable, and kind of add that leg motion in, so you're just curling at the knee as you pull in, alternating to the other side, and we're looking for 10 reps on each leg, so 20 repetitions total.
All right, and the easier version would be to sit in your chair. You're just going to extend your legs out and in, and then you're also going to put your hands out in the front with the chest pull. As you pull each leg up, you'll pull your chest.
Perfect. All right, so those are the four exercises. Again, we're just going to kind of cycle through at your own pace. If you do need to take any breaks throughout, that's perfectly fine. As we mentioned in a previous video, if you need to keep a water bottle in the room with you, that's always a good idea. If not, we're going to go ahead and get started. So if you have something like a timer on your phone or a clock in the room, just try to do your best to keep an eye on that time for the full 10 minutes. All right, so here we go. Make sure you're not holding your breath while you're going through these. Try to take those good deep breaths in through the nose, blowing it out through the mouth.
Chair is too much, you can always do a seated version, but just sitting in your chair, doing a high knee while you sit, if standing is too much.
Almost halfway there. Remember, if you need to take a break throughout, that's okay.
Anytime, if you need a break, you can stop and rest and catch your breath and get some water. Remember to go at your own pace. Hang in there, almost there.
In the last minute, let's finish strong.
Thank you.
30 seconds left.
Almost there.
Now that we're warmed up, we're going to move into the interval workout. So we have our work to rest interval here. So we are working for 40 seconds, and then following that session of work, we're going to rest for 30 seconds. That applies to all five of the exercises here, which Jared and I are going to run through in just a second. We're just going to go one by one, knocking each one out. Once we get through number five, we're going to start right back at the top at one. We're going to cycle through just like that for four rounds total. So the first one we have is a thruster. For this one, I'm going to use dumbbells, but remember, as we mentioned before, you can find items around your house, something like a milk jug, laundry detergent, shampoo, cans of soup, or anything you can find. Be as creative as you want to be. So I'm going to use dumbbells for this one. For the thruster, we're going to have the weights kind of racked at our shoulder, feet spread about hip-width apart. The first part of this move is a squat, so hips go back, chest stays tall, we stand all the way up, and then we press overhead. So you're kind of combining the two moves straight into one. So remember, pace yourself. Through that, we're working for 40 seconds, and then following that is when we take our 30-second rest. So thruster is one variation. Jared is going to show you two other ways that you can do this move.
All right, so the next one is going to be a sit to stand with an overhead press. So again, you're sitting on the edge of your chair. You're going to stand up, press your arms up, bring it down, and then sit back down on the edge of your chair, and then stand right back up, making that motion nice and fluid. The other alternative is just to stay seated and just press up and down and up and down.
And for some of us, maybe we're kind of not quite there where we're using the weights. You can actually do both of those movements that Jared just showed us without weights. You don't have to have any type of resistance. Even just working through that range of motion with the arms, kind of dealing with your own body weight, that's going to be challenging enough for some of us. So moving on to number two. It is a knee strike. So with this one, you're kind of starting with the arms extended out in front, and then you're just going to pull those arms in, driving the knee forward. Okay, so sometimes with that 40-second interval, you can do 20 seconds on one side and then flip over to the other side for 20 seconds. Some of you might want to just alternate straight through. However you want to do that is up to you. Remember, we're just trying to stay moving for that full 40 seconds before we hit the rest. If you don't want to do the knee strike, another alternative there is just simply doing high knees out in front. So kind of keeping the arms extended out, you're just alternating raising those knees, again trying to stay moving for the full amount of time.
Alright, and if you need to be seated for that motion, you'll just sit on your chair. Again, just doing a knee raise, kind of tapping that knee each time it comes up, bringing it as far as you can, but at a nice comfortable place for you.
Number three is a bent over row to a high pull. So for this one, you do want some sort of weights if you can tolerate it. Again, if not, you can do these movements without any weights as well. So with the dumbbells, what we're going to do for the bent over row, you want to have 1 foot in front and then 1 foot just behind. So kind of a staggered stance. What that does is just help us with our balance while we're moving those arms. So obviously, bent over row, we're going to bend forward just a little bit, bending at the hips. Arms are out in front, and all you're doing here is driving those elbows straight back behind. So you want to try to keep those elbows close to the body. We do 2 repetitions there. And then from here, we transition into the high pull. So that's that second part. The easiest way I do this is just bring that back foot forward, stand up nice and tall, and then you're raising those weights up to the chest out in front. One thing to remember here, you want to make sure that you bring those elbows up with the weights. You don't want to keep the elbows down at your side. So everything comes up to the chest, dropping it straight back down.
All right, and for a seated version of that, your legs will just be on the floor. Put your hands on the outside of your knees. Again, bringing those weights right by your side, elbows going back, and then bring it back down. All right, two of those. And then we're going to move into a lateral raise. So you'll sit up a little bit, arms go out, and then bring them right back down and up and down, two in that motion, and then we go back to the row.
For the fourth one, again, we don't need any weights for this, so we can set those to the side. This next one is just a jumping jack. So hopefully everyone is familiar with the jumping jack. Arms are going to go out to the side overhead, and then legs are going out as well. So you're going to put those together. You're kind of here. Anytime you're jumping, you're going to feel it in the joints a little bit more. So again, we can modify that to make it easier. All you're going to do, the arm motion stays the same. Instead of jumping, you're just going to step out to one side, raise the arms overhead, back to the middle, and then step out to the other side, arms overhead, back to the middle, just alternating sides.
All right, and the seated version of that is sit in your chair. Your arms will come up like a normal jack, and your leg will extend. Bring it all back down. Other leg extends, arms up, and back down.
Okay. And then the fifth one, it is called a dumbbell swing. Again, you do not have to use a dumbbell for this. If you can, you want to try to use a little bit heavier weight for this move. What we're doing, you can see I have a dumbbell. I'm just going to hold it on either side with both hands. Spread the feet maybe a little wider than hip width apart, and your hands are actually going to be out in front. From here, you're just going to bend forward at the waist, swing that weight up to the chest, and drop it back down. Okay, so what you don't want to do, you don't want to bend all the way down to the ground. You want to try to sink the hips down and let your legs kind of carry that weight up with you. Okay, so try not to bend straight down. Use those legs to help you.
All right, and if you're going to do a seated version, we're going to sit in our chair. We're going to do a front raise. So if you have weights, again, if you don't want to use the weights, just do the range of motion. We come right up to about shoulder height, and then we bring it right back down. So shoulder height and down.
Perfect. All right. So remember with these, we are kind of working independently. We're all going to stay together as far as the time goes, but if you need to add any extra rest periods in the mix, feel free to do so. Again, keeping a water bottle near you is never a bad idea. If you get short of breath or anything like that, take that extra rest time. If you start to feel dizzy, off balance, anything like that, just kind of take a second, reset, take a seat if you need to, and then jump back in whenever you do feel comfortable. All right, so starting at the top, we'll start in 3 seconds with the thrusters and begin squatting down, pressing overhead. Make sure you're breathing throughout. Don't hold your breath. Halfway there.
Remember, you can also do a sit to stand with the thruster. But again, if that's too hard, you can always just stay seated and do overhead press.
3, 2, 1, and rest. Good, so we can set those weights down. So remember, we just worked for 40 seconds, so now we're taking our 30-second rest. Remember the second one, if you're doing the knee strike, you're pulling the arms as you raise the knee. If you need to, you can just do high knees out in front, or Jared will be demonstrating the seated version. So starting back in 3, 2, 1, and begin. halfway. Almost there, 5 seconds. And rest. Shake the arms and legs out if you need to. Grab some water. For the third exercise, we will be using the weights. Remember, those are optional. If you need to just, again, use your own body weight, you don't have to hold any resistance there. All right, so starting back in 5 seconds, we're rowing for two and then pulling up for two. Ready, begin. Remember, with the row, you're just bending forward at the waist a little bit, chest stays tall, and then you're standing up nice and tall for the high pull.
And if you're doing the modified version, remember that you're seated and you're doing your pull. When you come up for your lateral raise, you only want your arms to come as high as your shoulders.
Awesome job. 10 seconds left. Keep it up. Three, two, one, rest. Good. All right, we'll set the weights down for the fourth exercise. Remember, that's our jumping jacks. So if you can do a traditional jumping jack, that's what we're aiming for. If not, we're stepping out to the side, raising the arms, or we're seated. Good, just with that arm motion, extending the leg out in front.
Make sure when you're doing your seated exercise, you're on the edge of your chair. We're not seated back, resting the back.
And again. Remember, our goal here is just to try to keep moving for that full amount of time. About 30 seconds left. Seconds.
Remember to breathe. Don't hold your breath.
And rest.
Ooh. Good job.
Alright, so we're going back to our single weight for the last move. Remember, that's our swing. So for this one, you can use something like a water jug. Anything you can find around the house. We have our feet about hip width apart. We're swinging that weight just up to the chest, dropping it back down. Ready and begin.
Remember, for the seated version, we're doing a front raise. So again, if you have weights or if you don't, use them through the range of motion. You're going to come up to shoulder height and then bring it right back down on the outside of your legs.
Halfway there, almost through the first round. Three, two, one, rest.
Great job. Remember, make sure if you feel dizzy, or have any pain, make sure you stop and rest until you feel comfortable again.
Alright, so we finished the first round. We have about 15 seconds before we're starting back at the top. Remember, this is going to be the start of the second round. We're doing 4 total. So we'll grab our weights starting in 3 seconds and begin. Trying to get as many repetitions as we can in that 40 seconds.
All right, and remember, if this is too much, you can always stay seated and just use an overhead press with or without the weights. Great job. We got 10 seconds left.
And weights go down for the second move. We're going back to our knee strikes. If that's too much, you can do high knees in front. If you're kind of seated in a chair, you're just lifting those knees, alternating legs. Good. Starting back in about 5 seconds. Ready and begin.
Remember when you're doing your seated knee raises, try to keep your upper body nice and tall. You don't want to curve into it each time. That could cause pain in your back. So remember, sit up straight and bring your knee up to your hands.
5 seconds left. And rest. All right, going back to the third exercise. Remember, if you're using weights, we'll grab those for this one. If we're not using any weights, that's okay. We're just going to work through that range of motion.
Remember, we're sitting on the edge of our chair. We're not leaning back. We're up and nice and tall.
And begin.
Remember, you're working at your own pace, so if you're slower, that's okay. Make sure you have good form, that's important. We want to make sure we're safe and we're not going to cause any injuries.
10 seconds left. And rest. Good. All right, weights are down for number four, so we're back to the jumping jacks. If we need to modify them, just stepping out to the side, still raising those arms overhead.
For the seated version, leg extends, arms go up.
All right, and back in 3, 2, 1, begin.
Remember to not hold your breath. Make sure you're breathing. You want to breathe in through the nose, out through the mouth.
Halfway, 20 seconds to go. Try to keep moving. Last 5 seconds, and rest.
Great job.
All right, going back to number five, so we have our one heavy weight. Again, with this one, feet are spread about hip width apart. We do not want to bend straight over. We want to have a bend in the knee, stick those hips back, almost like a squat position. And 3, 2, 1, begin.
And the seated version of that is a front raise. So remember, we're on the edge of our chair. Our upper body is nice and tall. We're bringing our arms right up to shoulder height, bringing them right back down, making sure we're breathing with the movement.
Halfway, almost through the second round. Three, two, one, rest.
Great job. Halfway done.
Two down, two to go. All right, so we're starting back at the top, about 10 seconds. So we'll grab those dumbbells if we're using them. Remember to go at your own pace through this. If you need to add any extra rest breaks, that's okay. All right, and begin. Looking good, halfway through the first one. Seconds left. Three, two, one, rest. All right, going to the knee strikes next. If we're substituting, we're either doing the high knees in front or we're seated raising the knees.
Remember, take this opportunity to rest, catch your breath, get you some water. That's important throughout the workout.
Ready, begin. Good, halfway. 20 seconds to go. Last five. And rest.
Great job.
All right, back to the weights for number three. Seconds of rest left. Trying to slow that breathing. And starting back, 3, 2, 1, begin. Row for two, up for two. Make sure you're not holding your breath while you're going. That breathing's going to help you move that weight. Seconds left. Three, two, one, rest. All right, almost through round number three.
Great job.
Going back to the jumping jacks, remember if jumping's too much, you can modify those, step out to the side, or if you're seated in the chair, you're just extending those legs in front, raising the arms overhead. Starting back, and begin. The goal here, remember, is just to stay moving for that full 40 seconds. It's okay if your pace slows a little bit. You don't have to keep up with us. Seconds. And 3, 2, 1, rest.
Remember again, if any time you feel short of breath or you feel lightheaded or dizzy, make sure you're sitting down, drinking your water, taking this time to catch your breath before you resume any exercise.
All right, going back to number five in 3 seconds. Ready and begin. Remember, just swinging that weight up to chest height. Don't have to go any higher. use those legs to help you get that weight up.
So you're doing the seated version, we're doing a front raise, arms coming up to shoulder height, body, upper body nice straight.
Seconds left. And rest. All right, going to the last round.
I know you're tired. We have one more round. Let's push through it.
Getting those weights ready. We're back at the top in 3, 2, 1, begin.
Remember, if you want, you can add a sit to stand here so we can stand. Sit on the edge of our chair, push it back up.
Seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. Yeah, so number one's off the board. We got four left, and we're done. Back to our knee strikes or high knees, about 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1, begin. Remember to pace yourself while you're going. Now we're starting to get tired, it's the last round. It's all right if we're going a little bit slower. Just trying to stay moving until we're done. Fifteen seconds. Last five. And rest. Good. Three more movements. Going back to our weights for number three if we're using them. We're doing 2 reps of the row and then 2 reps of the high pull.
Or 2 of the row and 2 of the lateral raise.
All right, ready and begin. Remember to keep breathing while you're going. Don't hold your breath here. Seconds left. Last 5 seconds. And rest. Good. Set our weights down. Last time we're doing the jumping jacks. Not jumping, you're stepping out to the side, or you're following along with Jarrah in the chair. 10 seconds of rest left. And 3, 2, 1, begin.
Getting tired, but remember, just keep moving. We're almost done. 15 seconds left.
chest. Very good. Last exercise.
Great job.
Seconds till we start back.
Remember, if you're seated, we're doing the front raise. Arms come up, shoulder height, bringing it back down.
Ready and begin. Last 40 seconds. Finish strong. Halfway there. 20 seconds left. Three, two, one, and rest. Awesome job.
Great job. Remember, it's important to do an interval training because we can get our heart rate up in a shorter amount of time. It's good for our cardiovascular system, plus we're getting that strength training in there. But it's also important to keep up with your walking. So if you can get outside or you have a treadmill or a bike at home, try to get in 30 minutes of cardio activity 3 to 4 days a week. If you have some weights or some of the equipment we showed you that you have around your house, doing the weight training 1 to 2 times a week. That'll be great. Thanks for joining us.